Hello everyone, this is Bread. I'm going to take another look at Exanima while I play around. So what I have done is made the shortest, biggest character possible, and I'm going to see how far I can get wearing nothing but boots and fighting with whatever weapon I feel like. That's the first thing I'm going to do and see how far I go before I die. How do you do it? What did I bind it to? E. I bound it to E. I've also learned that you can crouch in combat. I haven't been able to use it to a great amount of efficacy, but it is a thing that you can do. It only took me 2 full playthroughs of the game to learn that. There's nothing in that room. I'm going to kill everything that I encounter. Let's see how far naked man can go. Naked Man. I think I named the character Grumpy Dwarf, actually. Again, I'm going to attack everything I encounter, and we'll see how far I can get before I die. I may eventually do something like this on a stream, but I will admit, I am still fairly new at YouTube, and I've never touched Twitch, and I have no idea what actually I would need to do to start streaming. So it will require a small amount of research on my part. And before I do that, I want to worry about getting the scheduling in my normal life straight. Like, I want to be able to consistently deliver content on YouTube before I expand anywhere else, I think. Like, that's step one for me.
Yeah, sorry we haven't been posting consistently lately, guys.
Ow! You hit me with a candlestick. I've been trying to crouch some in combat and see. Oh, yeah, I forgot all about you being in here. Oh, ow. See, I'm used to being as heavily armored as is possible. Oh, no. No, 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 no. No one escapes from me. Unless they knock me out. Then you're pretty well going to escape from me. It's kind of a thing that'll happen. The only piece of armor that I may pick up will be that see-in-the-dark helmet. That way I can, you know, use two-handed weapons without being in the pitch black. come on. Quit getting hooked on the walls. And I know it's me, it's not the guy. But I still blame the character.
But you're controlling the character. So therefore, isn't it you?
I guess I will allow both of them to escape. Got her. Yep, nope, not picking nothing up. Dermot. I'm glad the environmental things like that don't hurt you. I mean, they should, but they don't. I mean, they absolutely should hurt you. Get back here. You can't escape me. Fuck it. Chasing him down's not fun. And now I'm lost on the first level because I chased them and got all turned around. Okay, now I know where I'm at. Filthy undead zombies. And so, also, ZM Ranger and I did have our conversation via a chat. Discord. Yeah, that's the word. Discord. The wife tried to whisper to me so I didn't look like an idiot. I couldn't think of it. The word escaped me. But we talked for like 2 hours. What I'm going to do soon, probably, is take the transcript and just kind of read it to you, maybe paraphrase a little bit. I feel like if I read it, it won't take nearly as long as it did when we were actively talking to one another. Down he goes. Mighty Dwarf Underwear Man is doing good.
What a name. Try to say that 5 times fast.
Bucket head. The first person I watched play this before I bought it did this. This was like the first thing they did was put a bucket on their head. Bucket head. But the bucket won't stay on my head, so. I wonder if I could pick up a chair and like put my head through it and just carry it around and use it kind of like armor, you know, keep them away with it. Yeah. I am the amazing underwear man that gets caught on everything. Right in the butt crack. I really want one of you to hit the other one. Yeah, like that. She buried that axe in his ass.
Bet that didn't feel too good.
I think that does it. Yep. Oh, ow. Ow. I'll try not to die in the first episode of me just screwing around. I think that guy has a key on him. And then I'm gonna have to go back and search his body for a key. Oh, I have been defeated. And if he's still hanging out when I come to, I'm really going to be defeated.
Well. Looks so weird with just boots on.
Well, I don't want to get my feet all dirty from the dungeon.
And that's what you're worried about, is getting your feet dirty?
Yeah.
Okay.
What? I missed a guy to kill, didn't I? Yep, yep, yep. Alright. Just come in here and kill this fool. I'm glad neither of us can swing. I think you have run into a dead end. Right, you better run. I'm not chasing her down. Wasn't there a guy with a sledgehammer somewhere too? Thank you. Owie! Don't fall on those sharp wooden spikes. They're bad for you. They're not very good for your health.
No.
I am going to take the healing item. And I think the first chamber pot, or bedpan, or whatever I pick up, that's going to become my weapon of choice, because I've never had the opportunity to kill someone with a bedpan.
You don't hear that every day.
That's kind of the point, I think. Boom, in the face. Now see, that would have been a whole lot more fun had I been crushing his face with a... There's one. Yep, time to put my money where my mouth is. Have no idea how effective a weapon this is. It's probably garbage, but... And it seems terribly slow. At least compared to what I'm used to. Naked bedpan fighting man, come here. Ah, the battle of the bedpans. Ow!
I don't think he finds your... You hitting him with the bedpan amusing.
I think that's a she.
Well, she.
I killed someone with a bedpan. That really should be an achievement.
Death by bedpan.
I killed somebody else with a bedpan. I am the bedpan warrior. Oh, that actually wasn't so bad.
Sorry, guys.
The bedpan's not as ineffective as I would have expected it to be. If you have a battle axe and I kill you with a bedpan, with as little health as I have, and no armor, zombie or not, boom, bedpan to the face. You know, normally we've been naming our episodes, you know, a number, you know, Exanima episode, whatever.
Yeah.
But we're just going to name this Battle of the Bedpans.
All right, that works. Battle of the Bedpans, Lord.
Look, so one thing that I've always been told, if it's stupid and it works, it's not stupid. I wonder what the ambient temperature in this dungeon's like. I wonder if he's cold. I imagine he's... Well, no, not if you're running around and fighting. You know, the heat's in the work. Now I can fight that guy with that two-handed sword. Yep, I remember you. My goodness. Clink.
Still can't get over the name Battle of the Bedpans.
I'm the Bedpan Warrior.
I don't know if that's something you should be bragging about.
I made it through the first level. I'd say about a third of it, I fought with a bedpan.
Hey, if it works.
Bedpan warrior. Nope, that door's locked. That's right. I knew one of them was locked. This is the level where everything starts trying to kill you, I remember. Aha! Another battle of the bedpans with a nut with a... Nope, you have more clothes on than I do. Ow. You're cheating if you're not in your underwear fighting with a bedpan. That's the rules to my duel. Nothing but boots, underwear, and bedpans, and a torch if you need it to see.
I don't think I care about your rules.
Hey, you. Yeah, you. With the butcher knife. Show me what you can. Yeah, I guess if you bash somebody in the face real good with an iron bedpan, it'll get the job done. Give him a good thwacking. Don't remember where to go. Have no idea. I'm just going to wander aimlessly and kill everything. So I want you to imagine you're in a dungeon exploring and you encounter a man in his underwear and boots covered in blood with a bloody bedpan and torch. And he's like, hey, how's it going? What's your first reaction going to be?
That's exactly what my reaction would be. I wouldn't know what to do. What would you do?
Thank you. Gotcha. Both. Doesn't matter what weapons you bring to the fight, no one can best the bedpan warrior. Ow! The guy with the sledgehammer is like, well, we're gonna give it a shot. Oh, crap. Look at this bloody ass bedpan. They're like, I think he had the runs. The bloody runs. It's like, if anybody's heard of the game The Universe Sim, where you're like, it's going to end up being like a where you take a Stone Age civilization all the way to Space Age and start moving to other planets in early access right now. One of the first plants you can grow is a bloody diarrhea fruit, as I recall. I don't feel like I'd eat too many of them. I'd have to be mighty fucking hungry to eat something labeled a bloody diarrhea fruit. Boom! Top of the head with the bedpan. And again. About out of time, but I'm gonna see if I can kill one more thing. Or get my ass whooped. Them's my options. Come on, fix your arm, it's all twisted up. There you go. You can't fight things with a twisted arm. I gotta kill one more person.
Just one more?
Well, I'm gonna kill a lot more, but for this episode, I wanna kill one. There we go. Come here. You think your board with some nails in it can take a guy with a bedpan? Another challenger. And another. That's right. Now we're going to put a whooping on the woman in here. Or guy, or whoever it was. I saw you. Yeah, I see you standing there. Come here. Bonk. So, ZM Ranger, I think that really hurt my whole argument for they try to have self-preservation. Just lean up against the counter and let me smash your face. But alright guys, that's going to be all the time that we have for today. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Dislike if you don't like what we're doing. And comment. I would love to hear all of your feedback. And I'm going to crush your face with a bedpan. Ow, if you don't crush my face with a sledgehammer first. Die. Yeah. Put one foot on him. Come on. Just put one foot up on him. All victorious like. Yeah, look at that. Look at that bloody ass bedpan and chest. Alright guys, you have a good rest of your evening.